In this GIMP workshop, we are going to combine four photos into one fantasy image. If you want to follow along, you can find the download links for the images in the video description. When we open our image folder, we can select all four images and bring them into GIMP by drag and drop. In this way, they will open as separate images. Make sure that the sky image is visible. Click the zoom icon in the top right to maximize the image in the window. Now we go to the menu bar and click on Colors. Then we hit Brightness and Contrast. Reduce the brightness with 10 and increase the contrast with 10. Then click OK. Click on the thumbnail of the stair photo, hold the left mouse button, drag the thumbnail via the thumbnail of the sky image into the photo of the sky. It will open as a new layer. The background of this image is already removed. Double-click on its name and rename it Stairs. Then we go to Layer, Transform, and hit Flip Horizontally. Go to the toolbox and click the Scale tool. Click in the stair image. Make the layer invisible. Lock the chain icon to keep the proportions intact, and then we can scale the image. By clicking the little center circle, we can move the image. Now click Scale. Make the layer visible again. Then we click on the thumbnail of the girl photo, drag it via the thumbnail of the sky photo into the image. Again, it will open as a new layer, and here too the background is already removed. Double click on the name and change it to Girl. This image too needs to be scaled. The Scale tool is still active. Click in the image. Make the girl layer for now invisible. Scale the photo down and reposition it. When we think it's okay, we hit Scale. Then we make the girl layer visible again. Select the zoom tool and select an area around the feet of the girl. Now we activate the free select tool and make a selection around the feet of the girl exactly where the stones of the stairs are. When we click the last point over the first point, we get our selection. Go to edit and click clear. Go to Select and hit None. We can do the same with the dress. Make a selection around the dress of the girl exactly where the stones of the stairs are. Here too, when we click the last point over the first point, we get our selection. Then go to Edit and click Clear. Go to Select and hit None. Now we go to View again, hit Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Click the thumbnail of the eagle to make the image of the eagle visible. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel so we can add transparency to this image. Now hit the Crop tool and crop the image like shown in the video. Click in the corner or hit Enter to apply. Maximize the image by clicking on the zoom icon in the top right. Go ahead and activate the Select by Color tool. Make the threshold 35 and click in the blue of the image to select the background. Go to Select and click Grow. We grow the selection with 2 pixels and hit OK. Back to the menu bar and now to Edit. Here we click Clear so the background is removed. Then to Select and hit None. Activate the Zoom tool again and select the area around the claws of the eagle. Click the Eraser tool, adjust the size to 40, and erase the wood. Move the image with the scroll bar, and erase the rest of the branch. Then back to view, zoom and again fit image in window. Now zoom in by pressing the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel. Adjust the brush size to around 20 and erase the blue on the edges of the eagle. When we press and hold the spacebar, the eraser tool changes into the navigation cross, and we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the image. When we release the mouse, we have the eraser tool again. Adjust, if necessary, the brush size using the bracket keys. Check the edge for more blue areas. Then go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Now click Image in the menu bar, hit Transform and then flip horizontally. Time now to bring the eagle photo into our image. Click the thumbnail and drag it via the sky thumbnail into the image. Double click on the layer name and change it to Eagle. Go ahead and make the scale tool active again. Click in the image and make its layer invisible. Scale and reposition the eagle. Click Scale and make the layer visible again. Then we activate the Fuzzy Select tool. Make the stairs layer active and click in the transparent part of the stairs photo. Go to Select and click Invert. Now we continue by activating the paintbrush. We make the opacity somewhere around 20. Choose brush size 0.25. Make its size somewhere around 400. Now we can make the side of the stairs a bit darker. Satisfied, go to Select and hit None. Activate the girl layer and click the zoom tool to make a selection around the girl. Go to colors, click brightness and contrast, and make the brightness minus 60 and the contrast plus 40. We can click the preview off and on, and then we click OK. Activate the fuzzy select tool and select the transparent area. Then click Select and hit Invert. Then we hit the paintbrush again and make its size somewhere about 200. Make the back of the girl a bit darker. When it's to our liking, we go to Select again and hit None. Then we go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window again. Go ahead and activate the sky layer. Make the other layers invisible. Click the Free Select tool and make a selection of the sky like shown in the video. Go to Select and hit Feather. We feather our selection with 50 pixels and hit OK. Now we go to Edit and hit Copy. Back to Edit and now to Paste as New Layer. Hit Select and click None. Make all the layers visible again and double click on the new layer. Name it Cloud 1. Drag this layer to the top of the layer stack. Activate the Move tool and drag the cloud to the right of the image somewhere over the stairs. Now make its opacity somewhere around 70. Then make a duplicate of this layer by clicking the duplicate icon at the bottom of the layers panel. Rename this Duplicate Cloud 2. Click the Scale tool. Click in the cloud and stretch it out a bit. Then reposition this cloud so it covers a bit of the tail of the eagle. Hit Scale. Now hit the new layer icon. Name it Vignette. Then click OK. Go to the toolbox and click the paintbrush active. Make its size somewhere around 700 and make the corners of the image a bit darker. And there we have it, 4 different photos combined to a dramatic fantasy image. I hope you like this GIMP workshop. If so, please like, subscribe and leave a nice comment to support my channel. I hope you have fun with this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching.